Greetings to each of you on this day. We welcome you to GLC Online, our online community where we gather for worship, to be fed by God's grace, and to be sent, as you'll hear today, for a healing of the nations, for a healing of all people, because God indeed cares about all of us receiving that gift of full healing here in this life. And so may today bless you in worship. As always, go to our Facebook page and our website, enroll on online communication so that you can be filled up and hear all that's forthcoming. Again, here in just a few weeks, we'll be beginning our Lenten journey, where we start with Ash Wednesday, journey throughout midweek with online and in-person worship, and then through Holy Week, Maundy Thursday, Good Friday, and Easter Sunday. So much to come. But as we live into that spring season of life, please find ways to engage and be a source of healing and hope for all people. We are so, so glad that you are here and journeying with us and with God. Well, let's begin now with our confession prayer. God of all hope and joy, the one who comes with grace and power, with forgiveness and strength, with truth and imagination, with gentleness and love. May Jesus enter our hearts and speak life to our souls. When our alleluias have been shattered into pieces, O God, come to us, sing a new song to us. When hope lies in tatters at our feet, O God, come to us, mend our brokenness with love. When we struggle to experience peace, O God, come to us, reign forever in our hearts. God hears our voices and listens to our hearts. God sees our needs. And so let us now confess our challenges. We admit that we allow the stress and uncertainties of these times to affect how we treat ourselves and others. Our fears, anxieties, and busyness have kept us from witnessing our presence in our lives. As a result, we have grown ineffective as voices of hope and grace at a time when those gifts are most needed. Come to us and forgive us. Make your presence known among us so that we may engage this broken world as the hope, peace, joy, and love that you need us to be. Children of God, be at peace with the understanding, through God's endless mercy, that we have been forgiven. God always makes things new. Enter into joy. Know that God will do great things in and through us. In the name of Jesus, amen. Unending love
Shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbid to shine. But God, who called me here below, will be forever mine. Will be forever mine.
A reading from Jeremiah 17, 5 through 10. Thus says the Lord, cursed are those who trust in mere mortals and make mere flesh their strength, whose hearts turn away from the Lord. They shall be like a shrub in the desert and shall not see when relief comes. They shall live in the parched places of the wilderness in an uninhabited salt land. Blessed are those who trust in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. They shall be like a tree planted by water, sending out its roots by the stream. It shall not fear when heat comes, and its leaves shall stay green. In the year of drought, it is not anxious, and it does not cease to bear fruit. The heart is devious above all else. It is perverse. Who can understand it? I, the Lord, test the mind and search the heart, to give to all according to their ways, according to the fruit of their doings. The Gospel is from Luke 6, 17 to 26. He came down with them and stood on a level place with a great crowd of his disciples and a great multitude of people from all Judea, Jerusalem, and the coast of Tyre and Sidon. They had come to hear him and be healed of their diseases, and those who were troubled with unclean spirits were cured. And all in the crowd were trying to touch him, for power came out from him and healed all of them. Then he looked up at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you and when they exclude you, revile you, and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven. For that is what their ancestors did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for that is what their ancestors did to the false prophets." Here ends the reading.
Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Put my yoke upon your shoulders. It might
Grace and peace be to you on this day. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of these words bring healing and hope to each of us as our faith and trust ultimately rest in God. Amen. Well, today I want to share words about the healing of the whole. Healing of the whole. As you heard that gospel text, it's obvious that Jesus is perfectly outfitted to be the one to come alongside and to provide that healing and hope for all people and all of creation. You heard those words that no matter where he went in his travels, healing, the healing of a person, of a community, was very important to his work. And again, Jesus is the one perfectly fitted by God to do that for the sake of the world. And so we keep our eyes fixed on Jesus as we look for our own healing today and always. All the stories of God that we read as Jesus traveled to and fro and were pointing to the kingdom and all that God would do, it's amazing how many times people were searching him out to touch the hem of his garment or to lower somebody down through a roof, to be present and to ask or beg Jesus to heal me. There were times where Jesus would encounter somebody along the way, whether it's somebody hiding up in a tree listening or saying, I'm coming to your house, or them searching him out saying, if you would have been here, somebody would not have died, to the man laying beside the pool who had not been able to walk, and him saying, get up now, take your mat and walk. Time and time again, the story is matched together as Jesus was testifying to the power of God that healing was a big part of his ministry. And I think what we'd say with that is that we all matter to God, that every single person, all of creation matters to God, that you matter to God. And I want you today in this worship to hold on to that, because all of us have our struggles. All of us are facing challenges that few people even know that we undergo in our personal lives. And then you exponentialize that as you go out into the community, into the world, and you realize there is a lot of hurt and there's a lot of hope that people are trying to hold on to. We all matter to God. But with that, I'd also want to say that Jesus desires our healing, our full healing. And there's three aspects that we look at when we talk about full healing in Christ. It's body, mind, and spirit. The three-legged stool. Body, mind, and spirit. Now, I don't know how you encounter that in your life, but how I understand it is that if one of those legs is being cut off or shaved down a bit because that part of our life's not going well, then the rest is going to suffer, yes? The other areas will be challenged. The stool will not be able to continue to stand. It's easy for it to tip over. And so when we look at our physical lives, it's important that we pay attention to our physical health. And in a busy world, in a workaday world, often you'll hear people say, oh man, I neglected my body, my physical health too much. I wish I would have done that a little bit better. And today I want to give you permission to say, yes, I need to take care of my body. We only have one of those. And when it is broken down, it's hard to live into the rest. And so pay attention to your physical health. We know how often when we need treatment or a surgery or we're not able to do the things that we used to do, how that challenges us. And so in that physical struggle, we'll struggle mentally and spiritually, yes? We'll ask different questions. We'll be racked with some grief. Why are things the way they are right now? I want them to be different. And to do that, you have to go on a journey to restore physical health. It's so important. We give thanks to God today for the miracle of medicine and doctors and nurses and all of these places that work on providing physical healing. So for you today, if you're struggling with that, know that God is there. You matter to God and God is at work in that way. Well, our mental health is so important. And we know when our mental health is not good, guess what suffers? Our physical health and our spiritual health, yes? It's easy to struggle mentally over all kinds of things. It doesn't take much to get topsy-turvy in how it is that we're processing everything that's happening to us. We think we have so much control and that we're the one who puts things together, and what we find out is so much of life comes at us, things get dumped on us, and then we have to figure out, now what do I do with that? How am I to live? And in our world, with mental health challenges, we know that that adds to the burden of so many other things. And often the issues that flow from it can affect family and friends and work. We know that poverty and drug use is often, again, tied into this mental health aspect. And we want people to be mentally whole and well, so we need to work on the aspects of poverty and addiction and all of that too. It's a whole 360 that pulls this together. But mental health, in a world where it's challenging to get the resources that we need, I think the church in Christ is perfectly fitted to be that small group, that micro community, and the worshiping community where we can work on better mental health together. Again, if that leg is shaved off some and that leg is a crack in it, that stool, that three-legged stool of the human is not going to be able to hold up very well. And then the third aspect, the spiritual aspect of our life. Again, we know that our spirits can struggle. We know how easy it is to be taken into some really dark places and how easy it is to lose our hope. And that's why we ask God, God, remind us always of your perseverance, of your hope, and your resurrection that you pour out. It's only because we know the power of the resurrection and the empty tomb that we can hold on to that and say, yes, God is with us and God is for us. Spiritual health often can speak life into those other areas because we will always have struggle. And so God with us, God for us, can be that light that shines through, that breaks through, and that raises us up. And again, the community called the church is outfitted to be in prayer, to truly come alongside and to pick each other up as we struggle in that way. But God help us, right? God help us. That three-legged stool, each of those being held together. And so if you think of your body, mind, and spirit this week, what are areas where you need healing and more wholeness? And how it is that you're working on each of those areas, who you're working on those areas with, be thinking about that and be engaging with God in the journey toward healing and wholeness. Because you see, you are healed, I believe, for a purpose, right? God does this with a missional direction for your life. What I would say today is that you are the missing puzzle piece for God out there in the world in bringing healing and wholeness to everyone else. And every single puzzle piece matters. Dear church, I want you to know this. You know, some families here, we make puzzles together. And our family typically only does that over the holiday. But how frustrating is it when you're working on a 1,000-piece puzzle, you may be taking a couple days to do that, you're coming up on 20 hours or 15 hours or 10 hours, however fast you are at it, and you begin to realize, I think we're missing a piece or two. And it's maddening to think, where is it? Did the dog eat it? Did it get swept out with the trash? Did it get thrown away in the bag of chips that was sitting on the table? Did you spill the soda or the coffee or the tea on the puzzle piece and ruin it? Because when you want to finish that puzzle, it's not complete if one piece is missing. Every single piece matters to God, matters to Christ, and you might be that missing puzzle piece in this world's life for there to be full health and healing. And as you look around you, we're all that puzzle piece onto the other, working for healing and wholeness. How powerful is that to consider? And the good news is no one is diminished when we say that all pieces matter, right? That if you're the little piece up there in the sky, that blue piece that looks like all the other pieces, that piece deeply matters to make sure that there is wholeness. Everyone is elevated. Everyone is increased. Nobody is diminished. Every puzzle piece matters to God, and I hope matters to each other and how it is that we live. Well, remember Jesus' vision from Isaiah and why he's perfectly fitted to bring healing and wholeness. Remember that he said he was going to bring good news to the poor, bring release to the captives, a sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to bring about the Lord's year of the Lord's favor. Yes. Just think how in each and every one of those, Jesus was bringing healing and wholeness to creation, to bring good news and release, to free people from oppression. This is how that three-legged stool is going to be strengthened. Physical, body, mind, spirit, all of it matters. And Jesus does that in how he lives his life. And through our baptismal promise, remember we're in the season of splash, we're called to do the same and to find ways that our puzzle piece and God's puzzle piece works toward the whole. We all have that purpose and that call and that mission today. And so this is good news for everyone. Everyone receives the good news the same, because Jesus, sometimes as we're out there searching and wondering, he is our missing puzzle piece. I think Jesus is the puzzle piece that I need to be whole and well. When I think it's all about me and my sense of control and what it is that I need to do, or how it is that I need to put something together, how it is that I need to fix something, I'm humbly reminded, no, the world has been here. The world is here. The world will be here after me. And I'm simply here in this time in which I have, trying to figure out how I can live into Christ, how I can put the doormat in front of my door where say, Jesus lives here. Jesus lives in my heart, in my soul, in my mind, in my body, and I'm counting on him for full and abundant life. You know, today, these healing stories that Jesus referenced, that people were searching him out for, they're held together with that Sermon on the Mount or the Beatitudes, the blessings and woes. And one thing that I've often been confronted by of thinking how blessing and woe we will always have with us, yes? And instead of thinking about those as either or, there's this and then there's that, that there is a both and nature to it. Blessing and woe is often held together. Today, you might feel incredibly blessed, and tomorrow your life might be filled with incredible amounts of woe. And if you are incredibly blessed, you know that you are called to get out there and to work on the woes, because what we want to have is more blessing and more moments of true life, wow kinds of life, healing kinds of life that we find in Christ, in community, together. I think it's so important to know that this roller coaster ride that we're on, the questions that we're faced with, the challenges that are out here in our world, they've been there since the beginning. And they're here now, and again, they're going to be here in the future, but we're called to work on it, to make a small impact. And it's often person by person, moment by moment, engaging in those hurts and hopes. And so today, I want to challenge us to think about how the church is a search and rescue team. How you are part of a search and rescue team bringing healing and wholeness to all of creation. Can you see that? In the words that you share, the prayers that you give, the ways that you seek to make a difference? That you are a search and rescue team for Jesus, bringing healing and wholeness to all of creation. Right now, I want you to make a sign of the cross on your forehead, like that search and rescue team cross. I want you to make that sign of the cross upon your heart, saying, yes, Lord, I'm part of your search and rescue team. For the three-legged stool, for the mind, body, and spirit in the world, I'm on your team, working, God, for which you will and work in our daily lives. And here's something else to consider. When we worship like this, through word and meal and song and prayer and all of that, it's meant to bring about some healing so that we can go out as our puzzle pieces working out there in creation, bringing it together. But we're only here for 1 hour, which there's 168 hours a week. 1 hour of healing balm to do the other 167 hours. Wow, that's a lot to consider, isn't it? And I made sure I used my calculator on this one. There are 61,320 hours a year. And if you worship every single weekend and attend some during Lent and Holy Week, you maybe got 60 hours of worship. 60 hours of worship to sit with our healer, our great physician, the one who works to make us whole. Just 60 hours to take on the other 61,000 hours of our life each year. Wow. So God has some work to do with us. But I know for me, Jesus is the appointment that I need. He's the one that I need to sit with and be centered with. He's the one who needs to diagnose, treat, and send me out with a prescription for how it is that I can live out here in the world. And it's not just for self. It's for the sake of the whole. And I know I'm whole and well when others are whole and well. When others are being raised out of suffering, I know that my suffering is being reduced as well. We're made to do this life together. Each of our puzzle pieces, each of our lives, deeply mattering to God and thus to each other. And so, church, new life, whole life, new life and whole life. Jesus is perfectly fitted for this. And we too, the church, are perfectly fitted to go out and to live in that way. So who here wants whole life? Go ahead and raise your hand. Even if you're in your living room by yourself today, raise your hand. Who wants whole life? Who wants redeemed life? Who wants a new physical life, mental life, and spiritual life? And who wants that for others? May you today be called and commissioned to be whole and well in Christ. And as you do, may you be on God's search and rescue team, the healing and wholeness of all creation. Yes, Lord. We live to do your will. And God's people say, amen.
Fall on Jesus, fall on
times the way is lonely and steep and filled with pain. So if your sky turns dark and pours the rain, and cry to Jesus, cry to Jesus, cry to Jesus, and live. When the love spills over, the music fills the night. Contain your joy inside. Dance for Jesus. Dance for Jesus. Dance for Jesus and live. And in your final heartbeat, kiss the world goodbye. Then go in peace and laugh on glory's side. And fly to Jesus. Fly to Jesus. Fly to Jesus and live. Fly to Jesus. Fly to Jesus, fly to Jesus, and live.
Yes, come to Jesus and live. An ever constant reminder of God with us and for us. And that is why in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples saying, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. And again after supper, he took the cup, blessed it, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Yes, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ given for us. This is a meal of life. I invite you to pray the Lord's Prayer with me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now taking a piece of bread and placing it upon your lips, body of Christ given for you. And receiving the chalice, blood of Christ shed for you. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ now strengthen you and keep you always in God's grace. And God's people say, amen.
Without you.
sin runs deep. Your grace is more. Where grace is found is where you are. Where you are, I am free. Holiness is Christ in me. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, your righteousness. Oh God, how I need you. Lord,
now receive this benediction. Jesus declares God's great love for you. So love all and serve all. Go splash in the light and love that God ushers forth into your world. Alleluia. Amen. Go in peace. Serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.